fucking there it is. Break. Change of Seasons, Dreamfeater, hello. Such a good, small little album they made. Hello! How you doing, little baby? You here to join me? What's up, everyone, and welcome to FAQ 162. Boy, how much bullshit knowledge have I been giving you guys with these FAQs? Probably nothing, but you're still here, and I really, really appreciate that. Thank you so much for staying and being awesome, okay? In today's FAQ, I'm gonna continue and answer some questions. So let's just start, man. Big Mike, Ola, how come there aren't any of those stupid advertisements during your videos? Seems like everyone else's channel that I watch has those annoying ads. Please tell me it's driving me crazy. That's a legitimate good question. I'm not sure if you mean the advertisements that Google puts in right in the middle of the video. I don't have those engaged because I personally think that they are annoying as f***. But you might be talking about the advertisements that the actual YouTubers making in the video, putting like a, you know, a paid sponsorship in the video where they, you know, about shaving your balls or you know, Raid Shadow and or like Raid Shadow assholes or whatever the app's name is. Well, the answer to why you're not seeing it on my channel is because I'm not making these sponsored advertisements or anything like that. Ever since I started solo guitars, you know, I don't have to do shit with my YouTube channel, which is great. That, well, basically I do whatever I want anyways, but with that, you know, I don't have to have the mid-roll advertisements and all that. I don't have to talk to you about shaving my balls. I think when you put advertisements like that in a video, you basically date the video. I mean, I want people to be able to watch my videos in 10 or 20 years and, you know, not hear about Raid Shadow Legends, you know? So, but now you're hearing it anyways. Look at this, I'm even giving them free promotions right now, but I'm telling you, Raid Shadow Legends is a fucking fraud. It's a shit game. I actually receive offers to make advertisements like this every day, and they pay a lot of money, but you know, my soul is not for sale. Okay? Thank you. Poot the Bard, fuck, even with the Solar Brand YouTube channel and being part of The Haunted, bringing you so much success, do you ever still get imposter syndrome? Thank you, and kick all of the ass. Well, thank you so much, that's very nice of you. Imposter syndrome, if you don't know what imposter syndrome is, it's basically someone, you know, gets some success and then they still feel like, oh, you know, when are people gonna find out that I'm an imposter, kind of deal, something like that. I don't necessarily see what I'm doing as being a huge success. The thing that I'm doing is that since I have all these things that you mentioned, you know, solo guitars, my YouTube channel, The Haunted, you know, my solo stuff and all, I don't consider them being a success, but together, they're part of a bigger whole that makes it sort of a success, in my opinion. So, I don't know, imposter syndrome, I don't think I have it. I think it's more the way of a Swede to just not, you know, talk about success or talk about shit like that as being something I've accomplished or anything like that. Fine, you know, I'm proud of what I've built, but I don't know. It's just not the Swedish way to brag about things, you know? Did you know I'm a Discord partner, by the way? Sarcasm, that was a brag right there. I don't like bragging. But I'm a Discord partner, did you know about that? No? Okay, good, now you know. Next question, Dynablade, that T-style guitar is so sick. Any chance to get a few versions with Fishman's someday? Well, that someday is today, my friend, look at this. This is a 7 with Fishman's in it. We also have a 6 happening this week, actually. With Fishman's and Evertune, how about that?
Alex S. When you record your guitar tracks, do you use a click track? Excellent question. This is very important. We need to talk about this, okay? It's actually not that important. But yes, I do record to click track. And yes, I do not record to click track. How does that work? Well, okay. Recording to click track is very important. I think it's incredibly important to know how to record to click track, because it will make you a tighter player. Now, there's a downside to this, and that is if it becomes way too snapped to the grid of a metronome, then it kind of loses its soul. It loses the groove a little bit. That's what I wanted to say. In my opinion, the best way and approach is to let a drummer record to a click, and then afterwards you record your guitar to the drummer and not to a click. That's the absolute best you can do right there, because then you get the groove of the drummer, and hopefully your drummer has groove, otherwise you're f***ed. But you get to record your guitars to that groove of the drums, and it's just gonna sound way more alive. And you know, this, the little swings here and there out of grid will make it sound alive. Both yes and no. I think it's very important to record the click track to become tight, but I also think sometimes it's important not to record the click track and record to just the drops, you know? Laugh is drunk and wet. Ola, what's up, man? I've been seeing a lot of divided opinions, but what is your take on Schecter guitars? Have a good day. I think I've answered this question before. I like Schecter guitars. I did not like Schecter guitars and how they were back in the day. I had an Elite 7 string and it was absolutely horrendous. It had a baseball bat of a neck and it was basically unplayable, and it weighed like a f***ing car, basically. In the beginning of the 2010s, they started releasing guitars with way thinner necks, faster necks, and they just upped their game completely, especially with like Keith Merrow guitars and whatnot. And after that, they're great. But everything before that, I just didn't like the way they played. But they really, really improved on the playing aspect, and today it's one of the top metal brands today, right? Isn't it? RL10, Big Ola, what's your opinion about the Great Southern Tranquil? I can't remember you naming this record that often. Thanks and love from Italy. What? Am I not mentioning this album? It's a great f***ing album. I mean, it's basically the best intro of any album out there, man. You just get a full f***ing boss out scream. Brutal as fuck. We saw Philip kind of dividing from the rest of the band a little bit because of his injury and, you know, his addiction and all that. And you can see some of that tear in the Great Southern Tranquil, I believe. And it actually makes that album what it is, in my opinion. It's a great album. Obviously, it has a lot of my favorite solos on it, like Floods and Tents and holy shit, man. Great album. Don't skimp out on it, just saying. Leland, whole fucker. It says fucker, not fucker, okay? You don't have to censor that. It's whole fucker. Fuck, Ola, how much does it cost to ship a solo guitar to America? All right, let's go and check the website. We have a thing down here, I think. Shipping costs and delivery times at the bottom. Let's check. We go down to the United States of A. United States of America, 35 euros to ship. It's not that much, to be honest. So there you go. Sometimes just checking the website answers everything for you, just saying. Alan Woodward, Ola, between the JP2C and the Badlander, which one do you like to play through most and why? All right, I think they both have their qualities. I think the JP2C might be the favorite for now, but I just love the rectifier-ness-y of the Badlander. I mean, you know, there's just... I will never grow tired of a rectifier type of sound, and the Badlander is a modern sounding rectifier with a little bit more edge, and I love that sound to death. But at this point right now, right here today, I will probably pick the JP2C as a favorite because it's just so much fun to play and it's chunky. Okay, Mediocre Fag, how were your eggs this morning? Thank you, James. They were excellent. Fuck. Mats Frander, Harmonic Minor, f***ing Ola, I love the Swedish punk. Why you never mentioned this? We need a top 10 Swedish punk band list. Oh, that's fun. So when I started my first band, we were playing basically punk, Swedish punk. It was a very short time where I was listening a lot to this. And I'm not gonna mention 10 bands, but I can mention a couple that I listen to. First one being Strebers, which is a legendary Swedish punk band that later became Dia Salma, which is also a very, very important band that I listen to. But Strebers, Swedish punk. While Strebers was one of the more serious Swedish punk bands, there were something called Trallpunk as well, which is basically like happy Swedish punk. De Lyckliga Kompisarna, Hockeyfrilla, which is more happy punk, but still very, very potent and very good. And me and my band played a lot of covers of these bands, because it was a lot of fun. It's not really easy to play too, it's like, it's just chaos, man. But I guess when people refer to Swedish punk, they're probably thinking about like Millencolin and eventually hardcore like Refused or stuff like that. Millencolin was more like skate punk, if anything. I didn't particularly listen that much to them, but because I was already outside and, you know, ventured away from punk and went more into metal. But yeah, Strebers is definitely a band I and DLK, De Lyckliga Kompisarna, is something I also recommend. De Lyckliga Kompisarna translates to The Happy Friends. It's a great name. Assmaster 420, stop the frickin' stupid background music. I will never listen again till that's gone. Goodbye, Ola. Goodbye. And that, my friends, was the last question. I hope you had a good time. If you have any more questions, please put them in the comment section of this video and I might get you featured on the next FAQ. FAQ 163 is the number of that one. Okay, thank you so much for watching, guys. Where's my dog? Picks. Yeehoo! Pixie poo! Pixie! Hejsan! Ska vi ut och gå nu? It's time to go out and pee. Hej på dig! Hej på dig, lilla tjejen! Tort. Va? Ska vi gå ut och gå? She doesn't understand Swedish that much, but basically I'm asking if we should go out and take a walk. Because, I mean, she needs to pee and have a shit, stuff like that. Ska vi gå ut? I think she's been asleep, so she's a little tired. That's okay. And anyway, guys, I hope you have a good day. Bye. Hockeyfrilla. 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 Hockeyfrilla.